going forever. Moments gone, time runs out, and then it hits you with a pain. Things are great on the way out, but nobody's with you when you're on the way down. You got what you wish for. Is that what you really want? Yes, how I think of you. Yes, how I think of you all the way.
The Nancy Reno time that you played with her when you were on, you guys were phenomenal. But it seemed like you at times just didn't have the chemistry going on, or there was, you know, some issues that were going on. How tough is that as a professional to work around that and you know, continue to have success on the court when you're going through that sort of thing?
Well, we had fantastic chemistry for a long time, but when she got hurt at the end of 95, heading into the 96 Olympics, we had some issues for sure. And, you know, I think she tried to dump me after we won 11 international tournaments in a row. She did dump me. And it was crazy. But we still had to play in another tournament together. So she didn't even stay at my hotel. We showed up at the court. We won again. And then basically it's like, you know, she went and played with somebody else and then decided to come back to me for the Olympics. But, you know, it's unfortunate, but it's also, I'm a professional athlete. It's my job.
Right.
I know how to do my job. She knew how to do her job. And we were good at winning.
Who was it that she thought the grass was greener with?
Carolyn Kirby.
Sure. Yeah, now that I think about it, I do remember that.
But Carolyn Kirby didn't play in any of the Olympic Games.
Right. You were known as one of the best defenders to ever play the game. In brief, what advice would you pass on to the up-and-coming generation of players when it comes to the keys and basics of playing good defense, Holly?
Well, for one, I think defense is a mindset. I mean, you have to have the attitude like you are not going to let the ball hit the sand. No matter what, there's no stopping. You have to give an all-out effort at all times, and it's really very mental. Obviously, you have to train the physicality and being explosive in your first step towards reading the ball and moving in the right direction, and then obviously controlling it. So those contacts and how you control the ball, really important, but it all starts with the mindset. And how bad do you want to dig the ball? Are you willing to do whatever it takes? And I was, and I loved that part of the game.
You did it well. It was inspiring to watch, I'll tell you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I still play pretty good defense. I play every Thursday. It's pretty fun.
Oh, you still do in Manhattan? Do you play doubles or fours or what?
It's my favorite day of the week, by the way, because I coach a lot and I do TV, so I get to look forward to my Thursday mornings. I play 4-4. With a group of all former pros. Some current pros come and play with us too, because it's a really high level. And I absolutely love it. I come home and there's not one part of my body not covered in sand.
You don't know any other way to do it, Holly. I don't think you ever will.
It's fun.
Can you share names on who you're still playing with during those games?
Yeah, well, I'll just tell you who I played with yesterday. So Rachel Walkholder.
Oh, wow. She was she could jump.
Yeah, yeah, she was great. Leanne McSorley, Nancy Mason, Lisa Arce, Gina Urango played with us yesterday, Angela Lewis, Nicole Brano was with us last week. I mean, Carrie Walsh is with us. There's lots of high-level. Jenny Kropp plays with us a lot, too. So there's a lot of high-level players that come. And then we, you know, cycle in the young pros, and they love it, too.
Yeah, well, look who they're learning from. You can't beat that. It must be nice just riding down the Strand and looking over and seeing all these legends of the sport. But probably pretty humbling because you all are still in such great shape and still play at such a high level. How cool. Those are the little things that people who don't live there don't realize how amazing it really is when you can go be 3 feet from the court and watch Holly McPeak, Rachel Walkholder, and everyone else, and Nancy Mason still playing. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, and we're lucky to have one another in this area because I know lots of former players who don't have a network of players that they can, you know, compete with. So I'm really grateful for that.
Yeah, absolutely. So you're talking about just a bunch of great players that you play with on Thursday mornings. Over your career, you know, all eras, who were the five most impressive women's hitters that you've ever seen, whether you played against them or not, that you just were like, wow, that person can really unload on the ball?
So, you know, for me, I don't really look at a hitter like, oh, she hits the ball hard, because, hey, if she hits the ball hard right at me, wonderful. It doesn't bother me. It's how good are they offensively? Are they putting the ball in spots that I can't dig it?
Right.
So, for me, I will serve you all day if you hit the ball hard and hit it right at me. So, that's kind of a tough question. If you say, who are the best offensive players, that's a better question.
Why don't
question
we go with that then, like that,
okay.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I think EY, obviously, is something special. Misty may, you know, move the ball great around the court. Terry Walsh, you know, she had such great offensive range. She could hit the ball straight down, but she also had the shots. Gosh, Adriana Bayar and Sheldon from Brazil were pretty darn amazing. I think Larissa Franca is incredible. I guess those would be my top group.
Okay. Now, conversely, what about defensive players? Who were the five that come to mind that you knew it was going to be a challenge to get the ball in the sand against?
Probably Jackie Silva, Misty, Linda Hanley was very good defensively, and Shelda Betty, too, from Brazil, and Adriana Bayar, and Larissa. I mean, those players were pretty good, too.
Well, I remember watching Jackie Silva on ESPN when I was first starting to play the game back in the late 80s. She was a firecracker.
Yeah, she was.
Do you ever hear or know what she's up to these days?
Yeah, I keep in touch, you know, just on social media and stuff with her. She has a little, in Brazil they call it an escolinha, which means a little school where she trains, you know, trains kids and you know, the next generation of players coming up.
Oh, boy, watch out.
Yeah.
Just what we needed to hear. The Brazil's already phenomenal, but now that they've got someone like her getting them started at a young age, that's going to be scary.
Yeah.
You've earned a number of accolades in your career, from the 72 Open wins, the NCAA title at UCLA, the 2009 induction into the International Volleyball Hall of Fame, and then the California Beach Volleyball Association in 2011, I believe. You were a three-time Olympian, and then the bronze medal, and then five-time Beach Tour MVP, to name a few. There's probably a bunch of Defensive Player of the Year awards in there, and Rookie of the Year,
eight.
I'm sure.
Eight best defense. I'm
proud
of that.
Yeah, right. And then looking back on that, I mean, with all the things that you've accomplished and all everything that you've earned over the years, what are you most proud of, and how would you like to be remembered from your playing career, Holly?
Wow, that's a tough question. You know, I don't think I have a big ego, so I don't really care. I mean, not that I don't really care, but all I know is I was given a bunch of amazing opportunities to play a sport I love all over the world for 20 years, and I'm super grateful for that. But I'm also proud of the fact that, yes, I was given these opportunities, and I maximized whatever I had. So, you know, I was undersized, whatever, but I took advantage of the opportunities whenever possible, and you know, maximized what I was able to do. So I think that's what I'm most proud of. Obviously, winning is a result of that. having a bunch of, you know, wins and amazing experiences playing my sport all over the world. So I'm grateful for the opportunity the sport gave me. But I think, you know, just maximizing my opportunities, that's what I'm the most proud of.
You didn't leave anything on the table, that's for sure.
I tried not to.
You know,
I feel that the same way about, you know, anything I do. Now I own a beach volleyball club, and, you know, we're in our sixth year. I own a club with Barb Fontana and Eric Fonoimoana, and every year we look at what we did and how can we get better, and, you know, I think that's important, and we want to help our kids get better, and how can we do it better, and, you know, so I think it's a growing process. It's the same thing with my TV. I watch myself on TV. What am I saying? Am I saying that too much? Can I, you know, what can I do better? Because, you know, I feel like you always have to learn and get better at whatever you do.
What's the name of your club team?
It's called Elite Beach Volleyball Club, and it's located in Manhattan Beach.
Wow, those kids get to learn from Barb Fontana, Eric Fonoimoana, and Holly McPeak.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's doesn't come any better than that. That's quite the pedigree there. You mentioned how you like to give it your all with everything that you do, and I do have to say, in 2003, I think it was, the Spectrum Club there off of Rosecrans had a clinic that they put on, and a handful of beach players, yourself and Dane Blanton, were all there. And one of the things that resonated with me is that, you know, you're here, you are this phenomenal player, yet you seem to be every bit is into it and just love being there and helping all the people that were there with that clinic. That was a really neat thing for me to see, rather than just going through the motions and it was an obligation that you had to do, but you were like really into it and really helpful to the people, and it was pretty cool to see the way their faces lit up. So I got to give you credit for paying it forward with those sorts of things.
Yeah, I believe in paying it forward. And I tell the young players, I say, take advantage of your opportunities and remember to give back. How lucky are you to play this sport and make money doing it and travel the world doing it? I mean, what a great opportunity.
Absolutely. Great mindset. You know, people now are curious, what are you up to nowadays as far as family? Your occupation, where are you living, and then what do you like to do for fun in your spare time?
Oh, gosh. So I live in Manhattan Beach with my husband, and I have a 7-year-old son, and I have 2 stepsons who are 28 and 30, and I own a beach volleyball club, like I told you. I've been doing TV for Pac-12 and ESPN and Fox Sports for the last 15 years. And then in my free hours, which there aren't many, I do private and semi-private lessons with aspiring high school players, college players, and pros.
Wow.
So, so I kind of do, a bunch of different things, but at the same time, I'm fortunate that I get to take my son to school almost every day and pick him up every day. And
wow, that's great.
I get to be a full-time mom too.
Sounds like you're living a pretty full life.
Oh yeah. Yesterday I just wanted to take a nap at the end of the day. I played volleyball. I did 2 conference calls. I did 3 private lessons. I was exhausted.
I believe it.
Yeah.
With the color commentating that you're doing for the networks and, you know, your club and some of those private lessons, are there any really great either indoor or beach players out there that are young and up and coming that we should all keep on our radar, Holly?
Oh, gosh, there's so many. I mean, the talent level is pretty special. You know, high school, I mean, tell you 20 names, but you know, if you look, I mean, at the college level right now, I think Catherine Plummer is something special.
Where is she playing?
She's playing at Stanford. She's okay. A junior. She is amazing on the beach and indoors. Just something special. I also really like Haley Harward. She's at Long Beach State. She's a sophomore. She's little, but she's explosive, really fit, strong girl. Actually, she and Catherine Plummer got a ninth in Hermosa Open this summer playing through the qualifier. And I think Catherine Plummer had one day of beach training. That was it.
Must be rough.
Yeah.
Is she, she's playing for, is it Joy Furbringer? That's the coach
Correct.
There at Long Beach State?
Yes.
Yeah,
she
yeah.
She went from the libero to the all-conference outside hitter at 5'8" or 9".
I'll keep my eye out to watch her this year.
Yeah, she's amazing.
All right, so we'll wrap things up here in a minute with a couple of quick fun facts about Holly that a lot of the fans were curious to hear. Favorite 80s movie?
Oh, gosh, I don't remember. I can't even remember decades. There's so many great movies. I love When Harry Met Sally. I think that's a classic. I love The Godfather, too. I think that's a classic movie.
Was there a book that you've read in your life that really made a lasting impression on you, or you would recommend for others to read out there?
Oh gosh, you know, I was an English major. I love reading. There's so many great books. I can't say one that, you know, pops out. But I love reading all different kinds of books.
All right. Do you have a favorite band or favorite song?
Not really. There's a lot of, I like a bunch of different genres of music, but I mean, I love Pink. I think I just saw her in concert, you know, in the last 6 months, and I think she's inspiring and talented, and what an amazing show.
Yeah, she showed up at a metal school, which is like a 80s metal tribute band that I went to on Sunset Strip one night, and sang 18 in Life with them, and then fell backwards into the crowd, and they passed her around. Ever since then, I thought the world of her, because how many people could do that, sing that song, Nails, and get along with a bunch of metalheads? It was pretty cool. She's amazing.
She's talented.
For sure. All right, and this is perhaps my most important question for the evening, but back in your prime, why did you always struggle so mightily during those practice games against Mike Dodd and Christopher Kyle Brown?
Who said I struggled?
I plead the fifth.
No, so what happened was, I think I told you earlier, like, my practice strategy was drill, 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 focus on our weaknesses, focus on areas of our game where we can get better. That's what we did all week. And then I think it was Thursday, I can't remember, or Friday, it was war with CB and MD. So, I mean, Mike Dodd, one of the greatest defenders of all time.
That's for sure.
And he loves the sport of volleyball. He played on the women's net with us, and CB is 6 feet, but a great volleyball player. So we had to play against these two guys who are obviously big, they're quick, great defenders. I mean, that's pushing the level. And they literally pushed me every time. And I played them with several different partners, but I just looked forward to it because we knew we were just going to battle it all out. I didn't always win. CB might say I never won, but that's not true. and then the trash talk, the fun trash talk that went on, I totally miss that. Every time I see him, I said, CB, I miss those days. And both of them enjoyed it, too, because they got a killer workout, because the rallies went on forever.
Right.
So it was really one of my favorite parts of training as a professional. Once I, you know, finding the right people to train against. As a professional, I didn't like to train against my peers. I wanted to train against two guys who would really push me, and they were fantastic.
Well, it sure paid off with the results on the weekends, that's for sure.
Yeah, and we laughed, we had fun, we got great workouts. It was, you know, we literally left every ounce of energy on that court. It was fun.
Great. Well, Holly, I can't thank you enough. From the sounds of it, you're an extremely busy person, and the fact that you agreed to do this on short notice and give me some time in your busy day means a lot. And I can't wait to share this with the fans out there. You'll be the first female player that we have done anything like this with on the site, and it's long overdue, and I can't think of a better person to have done it with than you.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah, congrats on your incredible career, and now with the color commentary, and I wish you nothing but the best moving forward.
Thank you. If you think of anything else that you need covered or you want to send me any other questions, let me know.